Hey crafty friends, it's Amanda with Pear Blossom Press. I'm back today with another preview for the Rabbit Hole Designs. They're a brand new stamp company and they officially launched today, January 11th. I'm super excited for them and it's been a lot of fun working with their stamps. Bonus, I get to show you this trifold tunnel card that I made using the caffeinated octopus set. Isn't it fun? I'm a sucker for a good pun. And I have so many ideas for that little caffeine molecule. Such a cute set. Now let me show you how I put this card together. I started by stamping the octopus with Memento Tuxedo Black ink. It's a permanent ink and it won't bleed when I color with my Copic markers. It's also safe for watercoloring, so I actually use it all the time. If you're not interested in watching me color, skip ahead to 1 minute and 43 seconds, but I'm just giving you the highlights here. I thought it would be fun to color her a nice bright orange and then add a whole rainbow of colors with the coffee mugs and the other dyes that I'll be surrounding her with. I don't have any fancy techniques. I just lay down the darker colors where I think the shadows would be, and I'll fill in the rest with mid and lighter tones. Aren't the rollers in her hair funny? And her tired eyes. I totally have days like that. In fact, today was a day like that. Luckily, my husband, he likes to roast his own coffee though, so I've got the good stuff here to perk me up. Anyhow, when I was picking out colors, I avoided blues and greens, except for the glass coffee pot. The water around her is going to be turquoise, so I wanted colors that would pop off against that. Obviously, the clear pot would be the color of the water, though. I love all these mugs. You could totally personalize them for whoever you're making your card for. I could see writing Go Team or something like that. And then after I get her colored in, I'm going to cut her out with my Scan and Cut. And I add a narrow white border around her so she doesn't lose any of her hair. Because she is already having a rough enough day. And then I've got a scrap of brown cardstock. It's textured, so I'm going to flip it over and stamp on the smoother back side. I'm making coffee bubbles, and I want to stamp the caffeine molecule onto one of the bigger ones. I'm going to line up my stamp with enough room to die cut around it. And then I'm going to stamp once in Tuxedo Black ink. Then I'll clean my stamp off. And I'm going to prep the paper with an anti-static powder tool. So I can stamp again with Versamark ink. It's a clear sticky ink that's going to hold onto my embossing powder when I sprinkle it on. And then I'm going to melt it with my heat gun. And that's going to give me a nice raised finish. And I'm going to line my circle die up and cut it out with my Big Shot. Don't worry, it's not going to affect the raised surface that we just created. And I want that circle to feel like a bubble. So I'm going to come in with a darker Copic marker and just add some shading to the bottom of it. I've done the same thing already with the other bubbles that I cut out earlier. And off camera, I pulled out all of the various underwater plant and shell dyes that I had in my stash, and I cut them out from a rainbow of colors, and then I just added some fast shading to those too. Now it's time to work on the card base. I've got a 5.5 by 16.5 inch piece of cardstock, and I'm going to score it at 5.5 inches from either end to make a square trifold. If you can't find oversized cardstock like this, you can always cut 2 5.5 by 11 inch pieces and then overlap them in the middle and glue them together. This is a stiff cardstock that I'm working with here, so I really want to work those creases. And then to help the inside piece lay nice and flat, I'll trim a smidge off the edge where it butts up to the fold. I think smidge should be an official measurement on every trimmer, don't you? Now I've got 3 bigger nesting circle dies that I'm going to center onto the front flap of my card. Once I get them lined up, I'm going to remove the largest and smallest circle and I'll leave the middle one in place. I'm going to tape that one down. And that might seem weird, but yes, the middle die is going to cut out the window on the front flap of my card. And I'm going to be sure to open the card up. And when I run it through my Big Shot, I only want to cut through that top layer. Once I get that window removed, I can save that circle for another project. Lord knows I never throw any of my scraps out. I'm going to fold the card back up. And I'm going to center the smallest die on the inside flap. Once I get it lined up, I'll tape it in place. And then I'm going to be sure to open the card all the way up. And then run it through my Big Shot again. And when I get this window removed, I'm going to have a tunnel card. There you go, quick preview. Now I'm going to pull out a piece of masking paper and that largest circle again, and I'm going to cut out a mask for the inside of my card because I want to create an ink blended background that's a little bit bigger than the tunnel. I'm going to line my mask paper up in the center of my card. Masking paper has a low tack adhesive on the back, so it's going to stay in place while I'm inking, but then when I pull it up, it's not going to rip the paper. And you can see that I'm holding the smallest circle that I cut out earlier in the center of my card. For me, that was just the easiest way to eyeball the placement of my mask. Now this masking paper isn't very wide. It's cut pretty close to the edges. So I'm going to use some purple tape to extend the edges out a little bit. And off camera, I'm sticking the tape to my jeans first to help make it a little less tacky. And then I'm going to ink blend with my Distress Oxide inks. I've got Mermaid Lagoon, Peacock Feathers, and Cracked Pistachio. And I'm going to go over the area twice for full coverage. I really like these Distress Oxide inks. And you can even stamp with them, unlike regular Distress inks. It's like magic when you pull away the mask. Now, if you're going to add water droplets to your background, make sure you remove the masking paper first. Otherwise, the ink from the masking paper can bleed through, and it's all bad. Ask me how I know. I wanted a smooth finish, so I didn't bother with the water anyhow. And I need to make one more element for this card, the sandy bottom. I use my largest circle die and then a wavy border to cut it out. And I'm going to use antique linen, vintage photo, and aged mahogany distress ink to color it, and I just lightly stamp some texture on with the two darker colors. And then I want to stamp my sentiment inside before I glue any of the layers down. I'm going to position the two ends where I want them, and then I'll pick it up with the lid, and now I can curve that stamp to fit around the circle. And of course I test it first. And then I'm going to stamp it using that Mermaid Lagoon ink. That sentiment is so funny. And now it's the part you've been waiting for. I'm going to glue it all together. I start with my sandy bottom on the inside flap. It's obviously the ground, so I know where it's going to go. And I'm using PVA glue in a fine line bottle. I know I'm going to place the octopus on top of that layer, but I want to glue some of the background pieces down first. Virtually all of the layers are glued flat. I do use a little bit of foam tape though for the octopus and a couple of the seashells. I also made sure to keep the back sides of the windows pretty since they're going to be visible. And I hide the back of the octopus with some coral layers. Adding some little details here. And then I want that white border around the octopus to blend into the scene. So I'm going to use matching markers. And then a little bit of coffee bubbles to finish up. Did those look like coffee bubbles to you? Did you get it? Or were you wondering why I had brown blobs? I don't know, maybe it's a risky call using brown bubbles. For my finishing touches, I'm going to add shimmer to the eyelids, the coffee pot, and the mugs. And then wait for it. Huge glitter bomb. Oh well, you can never have too much glitter, right? I'll just spread it out a little bit. And then I'm going to use glossy accents on the coffee pot to help it pop. And then she's done. Actually, after I finished the card, I realized I wanted to add some little white details to the suckers on the bottom of her legs. What do you think? Do you love this set? I do. It's available now at therabbitholedesigns.com. And to celebrate the launch, there's prize packs and blog hops going on this weekend. If you like today's video, hit subscribe and click the bell, and you can check out another card I made using the caffeinated cat right here. Then head over to my blog for all the links. Thanks for watching!